In this video, we will show you the functionality of the sections on the homepage. We'll come across the main building sections, carousels, static content, and collections. As you can see, a builder section with the revolution slider is already here. Now we'll add a spacer because we want to have some space between the sections, and this action will be often recurrent here. Here are its settings. We will leave them the way they are now and add an article carousel. Let's entitle it Article Carousel and select the blog. Here are our articles. Now you may change the layout for the article's content. It may be in a row, in a column, or centered in a column. The length of the description may be set on this scale. You may also hide the post details by disabling the option Show the post details. Now let's add a brand carousel. You can give it a title, but it is optional. Here are the general settings for the section. Let's add some brands. Select the image and add a link to it if needed. In the same way, we have added some other brands. Let's proceed with the other sections and add a product carousel. Here are general settings for the section. Let's add a collection. You may give it a title. We'll select a collection trending now and add one more collection new products. Save changes, and here is our product carousel. Looks good. We will move further to the section Review Carousel. Here we will add some slides where you can write a title, set the number of stars for the review, write a text in the paragraph, add an image for the user, and add two user text lines. We have added four such slides. Looks nice, doesn't it? Okay, we are done with the carousels. Now we'll proceed with adding the static content. The first one will be section Contact Form. Here it is. Now you may add a title to it and add an additional page. We'll select the page Contact. By the way, you can change the content of the Contact Form in the Theme Actions, Edit Languages, Contact. You see, all these text lines may be replaced by the ones you need. Okay, let's get back to the Shella editor and add the section information line. You can give it a title and choose the colorization style out of four. Here you can add or edit the content for the information line. You may paste an icon snippet name, which you can get from the theme icons. Let's try it now. You see, the icon is changed. In this section, you can add only four blocks. Okay, let's add the next section, Search Form. These are all settings for this section. Now let's add a subscription form. Here you can change its content and the colorization style. We'll move further to the section Collections and add a collection, for example, Women's. Here it is. Finally, we add a section One Product and select the product. You may change its layout to the reverse one. The image of the product can be changed here as well, but we will leave the original ones. You can also decide what kind of information should be displayed by enabling or disabling the options. Okay, now we want to change the positioning of some sections. For example, we want the section Newsletter Subscription to be at the bottom of the page. So we drag it to the very last position in the sections list. The spacer will be dragged as well. Now let's do the same with the section article carousel. That's it! Let's check the result on the full screen. Here are all our sections: Builder, Brand Carousel, Product Carousel, Review Carousel, Contact Form, Information Line, Search Form, Collection, One Product, Newsletter Subscription, and an Article Carousel.